Next, we're going to talk about the floating annotation tool. There are two ways to get to it. The easiest is to simply touch the sidebar, select the floating tool. Now, touching it in the center, I'm able to move the tool around the board wherever I might want it to go. Also, tapping the center will close the tool. To bring the tool back, standing here at the center, I can simply take two fingers, press the board, and the tool will open for me. Looking at the tool more closely, I see that I have a pen tool. I have a highlighter. I have a laser pointer. I have an eraser, a toolbox, a screen recording function, a screen capture function, and the select tool. This is the tool I use to use the board and to open apps. Let's open Chrome. Now that I have my browser open, I'll slide this over just a little bit, select my pen so that I can make annotations on my board. Blue probably won't work, so I'll select a slightly different color now and write the word stars out on my board using my finger. If I wish to erase, I can use the palm of my hand to just simply erase what's on the board. I also have an erasing tool. If I select the tool once, I get an eraser like on the back of a pencil. If I tap it a second time, I have an option to erase all the annotations that are on my board. Moving further across the tools, I have a highlighter. I'll select a different color here and simply use that to highlight text on my screen. I also have my laser pointer. Selecting that gives me an option to just circle an area and draw attention to it without actually drawing on the screen itself. Once I let that go, it goes away. Going back to my selection tool, I'm able to scroll through my screen again, move where I want to go. Returning back here, I'll go ahead and erase all the annotations that I have on the screen as we are. We'll select and scroll down. Now I have a tool for screen capture using that camera icon. Selecting that tool, you'll notice the cropping marks open up, and I can spread these out to capture the area of the screen that I want. Also, if I know the top and bottom corners, I can just simply touch the area and that will give it for me as well. I have various options with my screen capture tool. One is to save the image. Touching the save icon, I then have an option to save this either on my cloud drive or on the panel itself. We'll save it on the panel. Touching that tool again, we'll take another screenshot, and this time I'll save this to EZWrite. Touching the EZWrite icon, we'll take that screenshot and put it directly in to my EZWrite whiteboard. Going back out to the main screen, opening my tool again using two-finger touch, I'll move this where I want it to go. Let's talk about the tools in the toolbox quickly. Touching the toolbox, I have a calculator. I have a timer. I have a stopwatch. I have a scoreboard. And I have a random number draw. All tools that are available to me to use wherever I might be on the board. The floating annotation tool is a persistent tool, meaning it is available to me regardless of what is on my screen. Making sure I have the select tool selected, I will open my laptop and will notice that the annotation tool is still available to me. Just like I could on any other place, I can select a pen and begin to solve my problems or do what I want to with my annotations. One more thing that I want to talk about is the ability to a screen recording. If we look at the bottom of the tool, we'll see that red circle. Touching that will initiate a screen recording for me. The audio will be captured by the 8-array microphone that's built into the speaker bar, and I'll have an option to save my recording to the panel or to my cloud drive when I'm done. To initiate the recording, I'll touch the recording button. The annotations will go away. And if we look up in the upper right-hand corner, we will then see a timer that is timing the recording. Everything is being recorded, my audio as well as the writing that I put onto the screen. When I am done, I simply touch the recording button and that will stop the recording, giving me an option to save this either on the panel or on my cloud drive. I'll simply save this on the panel. Returning to the home screen, there are a few more things that we want to talk about with the annotation tool. If you'll notice, there's an X in the center. When I touch that X, the annotation tool goes away. There is a way to keep the annotation tool on my screen permanently. The setting for that is found in EZWrite. I open EZWrite and I go to the settings. Scrolling up, I'll see an option that says Keep Floating Tool on Screen. Selecting that option will now keep the floating tool on the screen for me at all times. Two-finger press will bring up the floating tool. And now, instead of an X in the center, I have a pen. When I touch that pen, the floating tool minimizes. Opening my Chrome browser, the floating tool is still available for me, and I can scroll just like I could before. One last thing that I want to discuss with you now that we're in the minimize mode is when I write on my screen. If I then select my annotations or my select tool, the annotations go away. As I scroll and come back now to my pen, those annotations are still there. The best practice when minimizing or moving the screen, therefore, is to erase and close all of my annotations before I minimize the floating tool. That's our quick intro to the floating tool. Be sure to look for our other videos to learn more about our premium interactive board.